Hello viewers, welcome to your channel Pharmacypedia. This is Dr. Shikha Chauhan and in this session we are going to learn about the cosmetic excipients humectants. The topic has been taken from the BPharm 8th semester cosmetic science elective. So without wasting the time, let us begin and try to explore the world of humectants. So what are basically humectants? Humectants are the functional ingredients for cosmetics. They are one of the most vital used cosmetic ingredient. Now, along with the emollients, there are basically the backbones for cosmetic formulations. Now, why they are called the backbones? Let us try to explore. So, the basic property of humectants and emollients are that they are basically the conditioning agents and they are used in the cosmetics to improve the look and the feel of the skin and the hairs. They have the excellent properties to retain the moisture. Now, what happens is that many formulations in the cosmetics need the presence of large amount of the moisture. So, the humectants basically attract and retain this moisture. The reason that humectants are referred to being as a hygroscopic. Now, what are hygroscopic? They are basically able to attract the water. So, same is the case with the humectants. They are basically able to attract the water and also retain it. So, humectants may be either from the organic or from the inorganic material, but largely the organic humectants are used in the cosmetic formulations. Now, the basic property of humectant is that it is able to absorb and to retain the moisture. Now, because of this property, only the formulation remains moist. You must have seen the creams, you must have seen the lotions. No, they are always moist. So, they basically comprises of humectants which have the excellent property to retain the moisture. Now, it is opposite to desiccants. Now, what are desiccants? Desiccants are the substances which keeps a thing dry. So, you can say humectants and desiccants are opposite to each other. Humectants are hygroscopic substances. Now, considering their molecular structure, they comprises of several hydrophilic is water loving, hydrophilic groups and also the hydroxyl groups. But amines and carboxyl groups sometimes esterified can be encountered as well. So, humectants are usually added in the formulation to keep it moist, to help retain the moisture content, and so the formulation appears and is able to provide the hydrated appearance to the skin. Also, humectants are accessory chemicals which modifies or softens the action of the embalming fluids and acts as an internal tissue filler, as mentioned. Also, it is used externally, for example, in massages, which help prevent the surface dehydration of the tissues and the skin. Considering the humectants' important role in chemistry, because of the chemical processes which takes place when they are being used. So, we know that they are largely being used by the process of osmosis. So, when in the solution which contains the humectants, the osmosis will take place as hydrogen bonds with the molecules of the water. So, once this takes place, the tissues are filled out and should appear less dehydrated. So, by the action of osmosis, basically the humectants work. Considering the molecular structure of humectant, which comprises of the largely hydroxyl and the hydrophilic sites. So, humectant basically work by their attraction towards the water, either from the atmosphere or from the body fluids, and that is why it is able to retain the moisture content. They are highly hygroscopic in nature, and the amount of water that which a material can bind at a specific humidity is also known as the equilibrium hygroscopic. So, it is determined basically by placing a known quantity of the material in a humidity chamber and then measuring the change in the mass, initial mass and the final mass after the absorption after a specified time. So, it has been observed that commonly used humectants such as glycerin are able to absorb approximately 25% of its weight in the water. So, you can understand at 50% humidity, it is able to retain the 25% and gain 25% of the weight. So, that is why it is able to retain the moisture from the atmospheric conditions. Under the same condition, another humectant, propylene glycol, is also able to absorb 20% its weight in the water. So, you can understand these are the substances which are extracting the moisture from the atmospheric conditions, and that is why the formulation remains too moist and it is able to provide the hydration to the skin by the process of osmosis. Now, what are the ideal cosmetic humectants? So basically, the ideal cosmetic humectants ranges from glycerin, sorbitol, and other types of the humectants, which we are going to study further. So the ideal characteristics which are desired from these humectants are like, they should have the high moisture absorption over a wide range of humidity. Also, they should have a consistent moisture content even with changing humidity. They should be completely non-toxic and safe to use for cosmetics. Also, they should carry the low odor and low color, low viscosity to make the compounds easier. They should be non-reactive with other cosmetic ingredients. They should have the low cost and they should be readily available. In today's cosmetic market, it is more important that the humectant is sourced from the plants. So they should have organic origin. Now, talking about the commonly used humectants in cosmetics, glycerin is one of the widely used cosmetic ingredient. So it is basically odorless clear liquid which can be derived from natural resources. So it is found in nature primarily as a byproduct of chemical reaction with fats and oils. It is also be synthesized from the petroleum sources. So glycerin is probably the foremost versatile substance in cosmetics, which is being used on the basis of its principle. And the principal drawback which is associated with that is that it is highly sticky. So when formulating with it, you need to keep low levels or find other material to offset the stickiness. So other humectants in place because of the stickiness of the glycerin is like propylene glycol. Again, it is non-toxic, low odor, low viscosity, compatible with many ingredients. It doesn't absorb quite as much moisture as glycerin, but is again excellent for this application because it does not carry the stickiness which is associated with the glycerin. So propylene glycol has a chemical structure like glycerin in that it has three carbon atoms. The primary drawback which is associated with the propylene glycol is that it is synthesized and produced from petroleum processing. It also has a bad reputation suffering from misinformation about it. So, conversely, most commonly used humectant is the glycerin followed by the propylene glycol. Other humectants used are like sorbitol. So, again, it is derived from the glucose, so it maintains a natural story. It is more hygroscopic than a glycerin and doesn't suffer from the stickiness problem which is associated with the glycerin. It is more expensive, which is why it is not used as extensively as glycerin. Then next humectant is butylene glycol. Again, this is a transparent low viscosity liquid that works well with the humectant. It is similar in humectancy to propylene glycol and makes a good substitute. So these are the general examples. Other humectants used are like polyethylene glycols. So they have a molecular weight of between 200 and 2000. Higher the molecular weight, the less soluble it is. Another humectant used nowadays is sodium PCA. This humectant is basically natural in human skin, so it is often included as a part of the natural moisturizing factor. It is again highly effective humectant and can absorb about 1.5 times better than glycerin. As humectants go, it is among the most effective. Then when you are working with a humectant, you have to understand that the humectants have excellent ability to draw and retain the water. That is why they are more effective for skin moisturizers and hair conditioners. Also, they are soluble in water, which means they are they get off easily when they are being rinsed out. That is why they are being used in white cosmetics like body washes, shampoos, hair conditioners. Then again, they have some advantages and they're particularly useful for the products they are delivered from pump packaging. With the movement towards natural ingredients, suppliers are seeking a lot of derived from nature humectant. So humectants from the natural origins, even honey, is being preferred these days. Thank you so much for watching the video. Please do like, share and subscribe to your channel Pharmacypedia for getting pharmacy related contents. Thank you so much, everyone.